I have a pretty straightforward hand here that curves out very nicely, so.
I have a potentially slow hand, but it's a keep.
Okay, Plains, Dauntless Bodyguard.
Rough. All right, your turn.
Maybe that's what we talk in karaoke when we get a million subscribers.
What?
The theme of the Bodyguard.
What?
No.
That was...
Attack for two.
Can we never do that again, Ross?
Yeah.
Disagree.
I don't think it's...
Protect the other bodyguard.
Sure.
Wait, don't you want to get out a little scrap of typed out note to put on one bodyguard that just says bodyguard on it?
Go. Nope.
All right, well, next turn we're going to hope to find some blocking phoenixes.
Benelish Marshall.
Eek.
Attack you for eight.
I'll take it. I'm at 10.
All right, quick shout out.
I don't know if I like that or don't.
Xingo with the tier one sub. Thanks for seven.
All right. Well, let's let's start with discovery.
No responses.
All right, I'm gonna bend both. Draw.
Brad's over here casting Preordains. I'm casting Healer's Hawks.
Chart a course. Draw. Oh,
but if you attack first, Brad, you get to draw two cards.
That is true. I should have thought about that. We'll put this Arclight Phoenix in the graveyard. And I feel like we have to stem some bleeding.
So you're shocking off that. Oh, that's Sulfur
Falls. No, it's another Sulfur Falls. So I'm just going to shock a bodyguard, bring back Arclight Phoenix, and pass the turn.
Yeah, not,
a, pretty
not
good
a
turn.
Savage turn, but still a pretty good one defensively.
That's a good draw.
No, stop having good draws.
Conclave Tribunal.
Ooh.
Get that Phoenix.
Yeah.
I'm willing to trade the bodyguard here for the Electromancer. It's look not really. It's not doing anything if it's not attacking. You go to five.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it could flip a Legion's Landing next turn. So.
Yeah, that's.
It's not nothing.
Sure.
Crackling Drake, draw your turn.
How big we got? Four or three?
It is
four.
Four.
All right. Now we need a piece of paper that says number of instant sorcerers in the graveyard. And now we need a piece of paper that says number of spells cast this turn. And then that's what they did at the Pro Tour. Just every time Yuya was on camera.
Yeah.
we got. Ooh, are, how we, much life have you down? Gained off of Lifelink, Ross? We need to know your life total.
Should have been just four.
Four.
24 to five.
Okay.
Yeah, it attacked on turns three and four, both after the Marshal was in.
Have I stabilized?
My hand's not very good.
All right, let's go.
I can attack with both and throw away the Marshal to deal two damage. That does not seem beneficial, so... I've drawn both my Healer's Hawks in the matchup where they're not good.
You're talking about they're flying blockers for Crackling Drake. All
right, I'm going to... Discovery... And I think we're going to keep that on top, put this in the graveyard and draw.
That's not a good sign.
I'm going to play, that goes up to six, and I'll play an Enigma Drake and pass the turn.
Is that interesting at all? I don't think so.
I want to give Ross my energy. I want him to win.
You just landing, make a vampire.
My turn.
So if I attack with everything... The two of my creatures get eaten. I deal two damage, bring Brad to three, and I can start
die in the air.
Making vampires. No, well, I mean, I'd gain four. I'd be at 28.
Yeah.
I'd be pretty impressed if you killed me from 28.
I could.
Thing is, like, if you just have a bunch of removal, you're going to start doing that this turn anyway. What I needed was another Benelish Marshal. How do I win this game?
You top deck reinforcements.
Yeah, that is a way. And I'm on 5/11 permanents right now. Yeah, I think I have to pass again.
Huh.
Yeah, I don't know. That was actually a really close attack. I think it's possible because you just get to flip the Legion's Landing and replace your creatures. It might be right to attack there.
The Marshals is worth so much.
I know, and that's the problem.
If Brad was a little bit lower, I think an attack there. If I get him to two or one, I think it makes a lot more sense. But only getting him to three actually is a big deal. Leaving myself with all ones after that.
Ugh.
no third spell?
No, I have a spell. Yeah,
it's just not one that affects the board.
Yeah, not one I want to cast right now. All right, I'm. This saves me from getting.
Yeah.
All right, your turn. This saves me from heroic reinforcements, right? No, it doesn't.
Yeah, you can take four and go to one. You got three blockers.
No, but they get plus.
Oh, right. They're three threes because
they get big bonuses.
Okay.
So I'm wondering if that means that I still just want to attack.
How much is it?
It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8's not a lot. Whatever, I'll just say go.
I mean, 8 threatens lethal if he doesn't block or attack with his healer's hawk and you kill it next turn.
Sure, I'll attack.
Okay, I'm at 16.
Wait, yeah, but removal doesn't kill me.
No, removal doesn't kill you. Removal puts you to 1.
Oh, I know what this is. Shoot. All right, I'll block and you still kill this. So yeah, I guess I'll just do this and block.
Okay, you take 2.
Oh, okay.
I gain 2.
You gain 4, right?
4, yeah, sorry. I'm at 20.
Yeah, and I'm at
You're 3. Fast turn.
So if I... All right, let's draw a card.
Yep.
Let's... Discovery. I'll keep both. Oops. Radical idea.
That's draw. Not good.
These both come back.
Yep.
And so that's... It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is 10, this is 9. You're at 20.
That's convenient.
I still can't beat heroic, but I can force this to block.
If he has, or no, I can't. Creature, you can't beat heroic by not attacking, right?
I can beat heroic.
You can attack with 1 and beat heroic.
Yeah.
You're at 3.
No, I'm at 3, and I'll get plus.
Oh, right. So if you don't attack,
I'll just say go.
Yeah.
Make a vampire in it, so. Make a vampire.
Sure.
Tribunal the Crackling Drake.
Yeah.
Pass the turn.
So this is 9.
You need to put 5 spells in the graveyard or slash damage to me and deal the blocker.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to do that. But what I can do...
You have like shock, strike, spell.
I can do that. Lava coil this. Play a Drake.
Stop having so many creatures!
So then I can just attack with this for 10 and your turn.
10 because you added the lava coil. So I'm at 10, you're at 3. And I'm pretty sure I have no outs at this point.
Yeah, you can survive heroic still.
That's not going to do it.
Boom! One more. One more to win all 3. One more to win all 3.
That was sick.
I had triple
Did
one
I
drop
it right?
Marshall.
I think so. I mean, I was watching the whole time trying to like give you my what I might do.
Right? Yeah.
So like, I don't know. That was a really sweet game. Man, Russ, you got to win one, man.
I triple one drop into Marshall. That was my opening hand.
Yeah, and you got skunked.
You did get what I like to call rickety wrecked.
Oh, I think maybe you should have sacrificed your Banosh, Marshall, to flip the Danto one turn earlier, but I don't know if it would have been enough.
I mean, I got that same 2 damage in. Mm.
Okay, all right. Well, we don't really have any questions, unless y'all have some comments or whatever, we're just going to move quick break so we can do
We'll just take a 3-minute break and then we'll come back, answer any questions about sideboarding, figure out how to sideboard. I think I'm only changing 1 card.
Cool. All right. Well, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
And welcome back to sideboarding. We have Taijun Hao's Boros Aggro deck against Yuya Watanabe's Is It Drake's deck. Not a lot of sideboarding going on either side here.
Do you not want to get me?
No. I think I'm all set.
All right.
On my side, just bringing out some of the worst one drops. I think Healer's Hawk is easily the worst card in the deck. And then Aspirant is next worst, just being one toughness and most of Brad's blockers have flying, so the Ascendant doesn't matter as much. I'm bringing out a couple, or bring in a couple cards that I think can close the game. Banefire, obviously just a great card for some reach here. I think the games are going to play out a lot like they did in game two, where I get Brad pretty low early and just have trouble finding those last 2 points of damage. So Banefire, great at doing that. And Lyra here, mainly for aggressive mirrors, but it just matches up so well against all of Brad's cards that I think it's a reasonable threat. I'm not entirely sold. It could just be right to like, go 2 for 2, but I want to try out the Lyra and see how it plays. This is a card that forces Brad to have either 2 removal spells or essentially just dominates the game. Just seems so powerful that having access to one is a good idea, even in a low lane count deck.
All right, what's up, Todd?
You don't have Entrancing Melody on the table. What are you doing?
It seems a little too slow for the matchup.
You brought it in every time you're playing against a white deck. It looked really good.
You do?
That's what you did. I don't know.
Oh, you brought it in against every white deck?
Well, it's really good against the Dante Vanguard, which you otherwise can't deal with ever.
Oh, okay. What did he take out?
Oh, I mean, they didn't show face-up sideboarding.
Well,
I just
tell me what you take out.
Okay, hold on. Let me use the fancy new overlay.
Some radical ideas?
From Cardboard Live.
I'm going to die to my own Lyra. I know it already.
All right, I'm going to take a Crackling Drake and 2 Radical Ideas out.
Oh, God, no. Please don't ever cut.
I'm bringing in Drake. Another 4-drop, and I'm on the
That's
draw.
Fair, actually. I don't know.
This is
feel
what
like,
I'm doing.
Sure. Personally, this I always feel I'm like doing. Discovery is the worst of these. I actually like Radical Idea because it counts as 2 spells for Arclight Phoenix, and yeah. I'd rather cut like 2 Discovery if you're doing that.
Sure.
When you're trading your Their Phoenixes early, there's a lot of value in just having more total spells to keep bringing them back.
Right. If you're on the draw, also I think cutting a land is never that big of a deal.
It's a huge deal.
Okay. You asked me. You asked me.
I'm gonna die to my own Lyra.
I don't think that's true. I think I'm just gonna have it in my hand on turn 4, and I can't take a Banalish Marshal, and I'm gonna look at Todd and yell at him. That's what I think is gonna happen.
I'm sorry.
When did we both get so pessimistic? It's like, what's the worst case scenario? That'll probably happen.
My favorite moment in the entire Pro Tour was in day 1, I was playing against someone playing Azor Drakes, and they just destroyed me game 1. And I'm Golgar, and I mulled the 6. And while I'm mulligan, they just had that like look that I've seen before. It's like, I am going to be Brad Nelson playing standard. My hand is great. Like, it's day 1. We're like X1. We're like 5-1 or 6-1. I'm going to beat Brad. This is great. And then I just go, elf, Vivian, just destroy them. And then they mull to 5 in game 3. And just I get to see the whole, like, the entire arc of a magic match.
The spectrum
match
of emotions.
Yeah, the spectrum of emotions for standard.
Okay, well, my hand is good. Let's force a game 3 here.
I don't think you're going to get it.
I've got a lot of my best cards.
A lot of your best cards?
Yep.
I don't even know if I'm going to... Oh, I'll keep.
Okay, so he steals tokens a lot, right? But blue, steal a 2-2 from History of
Benalia. Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like at 18.
It's casting cost, not power, which is hugely important.
19.
It also gets discounted with Electromancer.
Okay,
so
18,
yeah. We're both
3,
at 18.
Go.
If you go turn 2 Electromancer, turn 3 Shardist. Melody for 2 mana, you can steal a thing.
Adanto Vanguard.
That card is rude. All right, your turn.
Why do all the dual lands look the same? Attack for 3.
All right.
It's called a theme, Ross.
15.
History of Benalia.
I mean, right. have you looked at Stevens versus Izzet Guildgate picture 1?
Chapter 1.
Because they're literally both just a tower that's got electrocute or got lightning shooting out of it. Wow.
Go.
That's bold. You could just take the Dalton Vanguard next turn if you had an extra mana.
I have an extra Entrancing.
Oh, I know that. But, you know.
Pay for life. 14.
Yep.
History of Benalia.
Double history draw for Ross. Take my energy, Ross!
Go.
This is getting annoying.
And this is why Entrancing Melody's pretty good.
Fuck.
I'm at 10. History of Benalia.
What is happening?
That's the turn.
right, Charter Course.
Yep.
One, two. Oh.
Didn't find the third melody.
All right, well.
I'm pretty sure there's something illegal happened.
What happened?
Didn't you entrance two things this game?
Yeah.
Isn't there only one melody in your graveyard?
There's two.
Oh, okay. Sorry. I saw a radical idea over there, and I was just like, did Brad just put a radical idea in the yard?
Entrance and melody that attack you for three, your turn. You're at seven. I shuffled.
Look, Ross, you drew three history banalis, so don't you give that big doofus face.
I have four.
He has three. You might have doomed yourself.
He's so tilted. I know. He's so tilted right now. He still might win this game, but
yeah, he's still probably going to win.
He's so tilted.
Seven? Well, the issue now is I could die to burn.
Yeah, well, don't pay any more life.
Yeah, well, I know that. So I guess I'll attack for four.
That's it? You're not even going to attack with your Vanguard?
He wants to convoke with it, probably.
Oh, okay.
Brings you to 11. And... So I have this Rustwing Falcon that's definitely getting cast. And then the question is whether or not I want to go all in and let myself die to Phoenix to two burn spells by playing Vanguard and fully convoking this Loxodon.
Whoa.
Or I can just Loxodon with these three and have the blocker for the Phoenix. Brad's at 11, so if I go with this line and Brad goes attack the Phoenix and I block, then I have to... The Knight still blocks the Vanguard here and I only have 12, so he's just not even dead next turn. And that's if he makes the aggressive line instead of holding this
I'm
back
at
11. To block. You're at 11. Oh, yeah, you're 11, not 15.
You hit him for 4, yeah.
So that would kill him, but if he has a burn spell, then he can just stay alive by dealing with a Knight. But I'm probably in good shape with Brad on two cards if that's what he's doing. So I think I play conservatively here and don't play the second Vanguard.
All right.
I think you're taking the coward's way out.
Well, I think this is enough. It's not like...
All right, I'm going to play Electromancer, one mana Radical Idea, draw a card.
Yep.
Flashback Radical Idea, draw a card. Discarding Mountain.
I think you mean Jumpstart.
Yeah, Jumpstart, whatever. All right, I'm going to Jumpstart again.
Brad's winning by so much today, and he just seems like he's really mad right now.
What did I just...
You played Electromancer.
No, right. This is the board.
Okay.
Electromancer and three rads.
I don't know if I should have done that. I can block, and stay alive though, and you're at seven. I might want to block with this. That's doing that. That's gross. Oh, this is bad.
Instead of the second radical idea, you could just like play the Enigma Drake, right?
No.
Played your land for turn and then played Enigma Drake?
It's a Crackling Drake.
Oh, I thought it was Enigma. My fault.
What do you got, Bradley?
I think I'm dead.
About time.
I hope so.
All right, go.
So I block here. You can chump the two knights. That has you taking 8. So if I draw Benelish Marshal, you would not die.
Correct. I think you just take it. Yeah. If you draw Benelish Marshal, he's dead.
Go.
A 4.
Tribunal, he's dead. But I not blocking doesn't change the math of that. But
come on, why are you doing this to me, Deck? Okay, no attack with the Falcon, seeing as it doesn't make a difference in terms of what's lethal.
Block.
I'll let this die, obviously. You take, this is 5 and 4, so you go to 2.
Yep.
I should have played this first, my bad. I played this first and transformed it, and then played this. Am I dead?
No.
He set it out his maximized velocity.
Yep, dead. Well, I would have got blocked anyway.
That's yeah. Needed to draw a land to kill you with the reinforcements, but
not happy about that.
Well, I've won 2 games today, and they both involved triple history. Yeah.
Not happy about that one bit.
I mean, that's fair. I would not be very happy if I drew three gray cyborg cards and barely lost.
To be fair, if you had sideboarded the way you wanted to sideboard, you'd have gotten steamrolled in that game.
That would have been real bad.
It would have been over 5 minutes ago.
We got a pretty good comment from Ifro Poker. Ifro says, crap, I missed it. Sorry, the thing refreshed and it pushed
me. Why
did
he say
down.
Crap, I missed it?
No, he says, I can't believe Brad and Todd are too scared of Lost Merriam to fly to Las Vegas and make sure he doesn't get that trophy.
Well, I'm not scared of Russ ever getting a trophy with his team.
Yikes.
Burn!
Well, it's just the constant pain and grace curse. He's you know, he'll top eight like every event, but he can't win.
But
we're 3-for-4 right now.
Tannen's here too. Tannen says yikes.
But I will say that I am resting after I've got a lot of pro points. I think if nothing changes, that I will be platinum for the next 3 quarters, and I'm just gonna take the break and stay in Roanoke until the end of the year before Christmas.
Nice. One tournament Kane has a really good question. This is for Ross Merriam. Is History of Benalia a good card?
You know, I'm coming around on it. I think so.
It is a card that can get Ross Merriam probably the highest amount of wins that he can find.
Honestly, I think this weekend, Ross in Las Vegas, you should play Standard and you should play History of Benalia.
Well, your Standard player is going to play History, right?
You never really know what Brendan's going to do.
It's Brendan DeCandia. If he's not playing History, Mr. plays what, Heart of Kieran with no way to crew it.
Yeah.
Brandon was in the chat earlier talking about how much he loved green black, so he'll probably be playing Golgari, maybe.
Oh, no.
I think Golgari is a very good choice, but like building, like to lose the mirror game one. You can still win the mirror, but like building it to not have a bunch of Carnage Tyrants and stuff. All right, I'm keeping. My hand's not fantastic, but. Bye.
You're right, Brad. I had 5 lands. And 0 histories.
On the mulligan? On the mulligan? Ross has to win on a mulligan?
I mean, if he doesn't win this match, he's forever lost man.
You don't just want to give him a free 7 because you feel bad for him?
No! What?
Of course not, no.
What is wrong with you?
Tan says, my team great and we just going to win.
Call.
Yeah, you know. It is Vegas. We can go to the sports book.
Yeah. I mean, I would go to Ifro. I would go to Vegas if the flights weren't like $500 or $600. They were like $200 to get to Vegas, sure. But
hey, Ross Merriam, how much was your flight out of Durham, North Carolina?
$222.
You're flying like
Frontier.
Yeah.
There's a reason why it's only $222. Yeah.
I would rather enjoy my weekend at home and watch coverage. Okay. I haven't had a weekend at home in a while.
Clueless wants to know, Ross, is there a settle the wreckage in your Boros sideboard? This is a very important question.
There is. Yeah. It is still in my sideboard.
Nice.
Good start. Okay, that's good too. That's less good. Yeah, that's a keep.
That seems like a keeper.
I think it's bottomer.
If you're bottoming that in this match, I don't know what the heck it's in your deck for.
It's a generally good card, but I think it leads to my draw being very awkward.
Okay.
If this were a better card, then I would keep it. If my hand were better. But I think I actually have to bottom that. It just makes me too vulnerable to a removal spell.
What, creatures?
Yeah, he just wants creatures, and it was a Conclave Tribunal, and I called him basically crazy for putting him bottom.
All right, I'll play a Discovery.
Sure.
Yeah, we'll keep both.
Tilt.
All right, go.
Okay. Rustring Falcon, Legion's Landing, get a Vampire, attack you for 2. You're at 18.
Take it.
Bang! Zoom.
I'm just going to Lava Coil that. Your turn.
I like how a lot of games against this White Weenie deck just are, hey, can you keep them from flipping Legion's Landing? If yes, you win.
Yeah.
If no, you lose.
Go.
3-4.
Apparently, 3-4. If Brad had put a Charter Course in his graveyard on turn 2,
I thought I had to keep it.
I don't know if you... I think you did too. Man. But it is looking... I guess it's not that big of a deal here. But you're not really want to block the Luxodon anyway.
Yeah.
I don't... I think I just attacked for 4. Because 16. Transforming... 14.
Or 14, yeah.
Transforming the landing doesn't do a lot here because I have a Odonto Vanguard to cast. Pass.
All right, well, we have to 1, 2 discard a phoenix. Discovery?
Yep.
Ponder!
No 1-mana spell?
Go.
We in trouble.
We got a shot.
Are we in trouble?
I think so.
Can I not stabilize next turn?
Maybe.
Ugh. Is there another spell in your hand? Sure.
Transform.
Yeah, you got to transform. I will block your Odonto. Your
Odonto. The Vanguard?
Yeah, it's a 3, right?
How many spells you got right now?
Or should I? I mean, I might be able to kill him.
I think you might need to...
it's only 7. No, only seven? I'll block Rustwing.
Rustwing? Okay. So you take 9. I gain 2. So I'm at 22, and you're at 5.
And you flip that, and it's
my
turn.
And that's transformed, and I've just got a land pass.
All right, well... all right, well... I guess we can do that next turn. All right. Or is it better to do that this turn?
I don't know. I think it's better to get Mystic in play.
Yeah, Mystic, go.
You're at 5, Brad? Is that right?
Yeah.
Wow. So a lot of damage output from this.
So you need a spell here, which I assume you have.
Maybe.
Okay.
What do you need?
Heroic reinforcements, baby.
Reinforcements.
I was gonna knock my deck, and you prevented me from doing so, like a jerk.
Wow.
I still don't know what it was.
Such bad manners.
All right.
Please be a blink of an eye. Blink of an eye.
I don't know if I should cast that. I think I should just flash this back. All right, I'm going to jumpstart discarding Arclight Phoenix. Trigger.
It's a burn!
Draw. Look here. Look here and block here. And take 3. And you're going
to
pay?
Yeah, I'll go to 18 and then up to 21. Sure. So I'm paying 4 life for this. That brings me to 18. These gain 3 to 21. You take 3, go to 2 life.
Yep.
So I lose the...
Just that.
Just this. I will play another Vanguard and pass the turn.
All right, now I feel pretty good.
Still, you feel pretty good? I thought that was a pretty good draw.
Really?
You're at 2. It's just another creature I can still...
I have 2 Phoenix and a Murmuring Mystic in play. Trigger. Let's get these birds ready. All right, trigger.
I mean, your deck doesn't have burn spells. He's going to make a bunch of birds.
Does it?
A Banefire? Okay. All right.
There we go. All right. We'll discard this.
Actually, this is me, right? I have to come knock it because I only hit fireballs when I knock the deck.
I'm going to play an Electromancer.
Oh, Electromancer. If you just had 3 spells here, then Reinforcements was lethal.
I'm going to play Opt, trigger the bird. Scry this to the bottom. Draw. I haven't played a land yet. I haven't.
That's true. You play Mystic and Radical Idea.
I'll play a Radical Idea, trigger, make another bird, draw a card, and that's enough to trigger my bird, my phoenixes. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's 9 power. I will, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. You have no flyers though, right?
Correct.
That's pretty convenient for me. Sure, I'll just attack for 9.
I'm at 12.
Go.
End step, make a vampire.
You got it.
Well, do you want to knock?
Oh yeah, because based on Brad's play, I assume he's not dead to heroic reinforcements. He's probably got a shock or an opt.
Oh, no, no, no. I don't want a Todd knock on a burn spell.
What? No, it's a fireball. It's just the one I've made.
Yeah, from. I know. Absolutely. That's a burn spell.
Come on, Ross. Let's go. Yes! Yes, we did! I gave you my hand! We did it! Yes! Oh, my God, we did it!
Yeah, it resolves.
Target you.
Yeah, 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 you win.
I told Todd you, was the teacher I told all
you,
along.
I told you not to do it, Todd.
We didn't know it. Todd was the teacher the entire time. Just hiding well, back there.
My deck with the radical hand. I was just going to just light you up. Do you know that both decks were stacked to just do disgusting things next turn? I had two Phoenixes with radical next turn.
What a day.
Yeah, I don't even know where to go with from there.
Well, I think we've learned how to beat these white weenie decks.
Yeah.
Peel?
I struggled so much.
Yeah.
I won out at you and had triple history in the other two games that I won today.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, maybe. I mean, okay, so from my inclinations playing against the white weenie decks in the past 2 weeks, basically, Wild Growth Walker is the way that like green decks can proactively engage with these decks and stem the bleeding long enough, build a big enough board, usually clear with finality. You know, the end. Still just I'm
basking.
I'm shaking from that.
Yeah.
Dude, that was so good.
That was actually really good.
Yeah, that was great.
It just never fails. I'm going to pay Todd to come to Vegas.
Dude, let's go. You want me on your team? Just say, Todd, I need a top deck. I need a fireball.
Yeah.
It's coming.
Just Todd, burn. Todd just has to, like, go.
No, he's playing Dredge. I have to knock five times so Stinkweed Imp hits a conflagrate.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Anywho, so, like, green has Wild Growth Walker, right?
Yeah.
Red decks need some sort of sweeper, I think. Although this version of the Yuya's deck wasn't playing Fire Cannon.
I don't think you need a sweeper.
Sure. I think control decks absolutely need to hit Clarion on turn three or they're dead.
Like yep.
The decks are just too fast and like the white mirrors are very combat oriented. I think on the play, if you have history, you're pretty advantageous or pretty advantaged. And then what black just gets rolled by these decks though, I think. Like Grixis decks, Disinformation Campaign decks, they're just too slow.
Yeah, those decks just aren't good though.
I think Murmuring Mystic is and Entrancing Melody are must-haves for this matchup. They both seem great. But if you were looking to beat Boros for the weekend, I would play Golgari skewed against it or Mono Red.
Yeah.
I think Golgari is my deck of choice. I'm able
Shocker.
To
Shocker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chain Whirler or Golgari.
Yeah.
My throat hurts. I was just screaming.
Oh, I'm exhausted. This has been a fun, exciting day.
Yeah, our record kind of blew up too.
I think this has been my favorite episode of Versus Live that we've done. Fun.
You got to play History of Benalia for 3 hours straight.
Yeah, but I was getting beat up a lot. Yeah. But the episode was great. We got the new Cardboard Live.
Cardboard Live was awesome. Wilson was awesome to be on the show.
Yeah, we had Wilson here. That was great. We got to do the whole history theme. That was fun.
Yeah.
That was actually way more fun than just playing History of Bedalia.
Yeah.
And then we had the insane one-outer right at the end. Everything was great. I don't even care that I lost five other games.
Yeah.
I just want to know how Todd always finds the fireball.
I have no idea. Magical superpower. Most of the time I have the fireball I need to land. And then both times it's been exactly Sulfur Falls. Because if it was a Steam Vince, I would have died. Because I was at 1 once and I was at 2 once.
Wow.
But yeah. Dude,
when you're playing online, do you like knock your computer somewhere to try to top deck?
He has multiple screens just on unlock to help.
Yeah.
Like in the PTQs, he's like, oh, I got to set up a new one.
Just buys cheap monitors solely to punch them.
I've heard of that, of like old poker people back in like when they played poker all the time. They just had a box of mice. Well, like of mouse. I don't know how to say that for
computer mice.
Just ready so that when they lost a big hand and they just slammed and smashed their mouse, that they could quick hit, put in another one. I was like, why don't you just control yourself more? It's like, you don't understand.
Yeah. I mean, when you lose $7,000 in a day,
yeah,
you break stuff.
Well, that's why this is the greatest game of all time, because we play matches for that amount of money sometimes. And if it's just a top deck and we come back for more. It's the greatest game in the world. And on that note, I'm quitting because that cut me deep.
That was great.
I wanted the 3-0.
Oh, that was a good day.
I'm going to put that one in my player bio. Made Brad Nelson retire.
All right. Let's plug the rest of the week. This weekend, we have SCG Tour is taking a trip all the way down to Las Vegas, Nevada,
yep.
where we'll have Nevada. A team open. It's the first West Coast Open we've had in time. Ross is going to be hopefully not making top 8 because he's a jerk.
I will be playing with
what
Tana
are you talking
Grace.
About? I want them to get as close to the trophy and fail again.
Oh, yeah.
It's so much
just
fun to watch.
Another second place.
So it's hubris. Oh. Sometimes they top deck a card and they're like, there's no way I could lose. And then they lose immediately. And it's so.
Yeah. Thanks, David Thompson. It's okay. Oh, no. Woe is me. We got second again. Shut up, Ross.
I did go 7-9 in that tournament.
Yeah, 7-9, and you got handed like $1,500 or however much y'all won.
A little more than that.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Just a reminder about the tournament in Vegas. We'll be starting at 10:30 local time in Vegas. It'll be 1:30 East Coast time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just so everybody knows.
Yeah, it is going to be on Pacific time, so we will be starting a little bit later than normal.
Who we got doing the coverage on that?
Cedric and Patrick.
Ooh.
The Dream Team.
I'll be watching.
Of course, Cedric and Patrick would be casting the tournament in Vegas.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, because they both very much enjoy going to Vegas.
Yeah, it's also an easy flight for both of them.
That's true. Well, Patrick now lives in like Colorado. So
he's in Denver. Cedric's mm-hmm. in Seattle. Two easy flights, so that makes sense. So they're going to be there. If you're on the West Coast and you're one of the people that keeps complaining that we'd never go to the West Coast, show out. I know it's a pretty easy drive from LA. I've made that drive several times. Pretty sure it's an easy drive from Phoenix. It's not that long.
Dude, we don't need geography lessons.
Everyone knows how far they are.
So we got plenty of people that can come out to Vegas. Obviously, if you can't, watch it on this channel, twitch.tv/SCGTour.
And then Todd and I will be back on Thursday, right? We're going to be battling some more.
Nick Miller says, I will also be there, chop liver, et cetera.
Yeah.
Because we're all talking about Cedric and Patrick. No one cares about Nick Miller.
I care about Nick Miller.
He's being self-deprecating. Nick Miller does a great job over in the sideboard. He's been helping us a lot here on Versus Live, too. So make sure to go follow him on Twitter. Yeah. I think he's just at Nick Thos. He's in Twitch right now.
I will not be here for Versus Live on Thursday. I'm flying out a day early for the Open in Vegas. Going to acclimate to the time change. Also takes a while to fly all the way out there.
Also.
Thank you.
Also. I don't know. Anyway, me and Brad are going to be here Thursday. What do you think we're going to play Standard again? I don't know what we're doing. We're figuring it out. We're going to figure it out tomorrow.
We're going to figure it out soon. But all I know is I am hungry. And I just got Bane fired for lethal when I was going to win with Mystic. So I'm going to say we had a good show, everyone. Check out Cardboard Live or cardboard.live if you want to add the extension to your own stream, or if you want to send any feedback
to Mr. Hunter Wilson.
Yeah, to Wilson Hunter.
Wilson Hunter.
Any feedback? Because I think that this extension is going to be great. It's just a great way to be able to see both decks on coverage.
It's a great way to integrate the information that the audience needs within the stream in a seamless way.
Oh, and just being able to just like clip a deck that looks interesting right to Arena immediately sounds awesome for me. Anything that makes my Arena experience easier and more enjoyable, I am all for, because like I said earlier, I got home and usually I don't do anything magic related on that Monday after driving on Sunday, or especially like it was a good pro tour, but it was like not as good as I wanted. And everyone has those tournaments where you still did good and you're happy, but it's bittersweet. And I don't want anything to do with Magic on that day, but I still played Magic.
Oh, real quick. Dan May, fellow director, says Desert Bus for Hope are still happening.
They're still going on?
They are raising a lot of money for Child Friday, I think, right? Make sure to head over to twitch.tv/Desert Bus after we conclude the broadcast here today, and then give them a check. And if you can donate, please do. It's very much appreciated. It goes towards a great cause.
goes towards Child's Play, a charity that helps children in pediatric hospitals and other child welfare facilities through the joys of gaming.
All right. Well, that will be our show for today. Thank you for watching. We will be back on Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time here at SCG, or twitch.tv/SCGTour. But thank you for watching, everyone, and we'll see you later.
Also, don't read Ross's article. It's live right now.
That's true.
Plugs, plugs, plugs.
May you top deck Banefire.